How you doing?
Candra's a teacher. She and her husband have come here from a small town in Georgia.
I've got 6 tattoos already, and this tattoo is my first one that has a lot of meaning. I've always loved it as a form of self-expression. You've got a lot of canvas with your body, why not decorate it?
Thinking Japanese geisha.
What's this?
It's part of the back piece I wanted. I liked all the Japanese themes. Cherry blossoms, the waves, the koi. Just stuff I wanted on my back, but I didn't want anything anime, anything cartoonish. I wanted to stick to authentic Japanese art as possible.
Cool, cool.
I love doing Japanese work. It's what I like doing most, so I'm pretty happy about that.
I like her face, I like the hair. That's what's most important to me, the traditional Japanese look.
Okay.
So if you could keep that, that would be awesome.
No problem.
The geisha really represents just educated, smart women who are looked up for not only for their beauty, but for their grace and their knowledge of poetry, of ritual. It's just really just a visual representation of all the respect and admiration I have for that culture.
All right, let me just sketch this out, and we'll get started.
Good stuff, thank you.
My pleasure.
Thank you.
Thanks.
All right.
I've been looking forward to this. I can finally get to work on Kenja's geisha.
Where's it going?
Shoulder.
This side.
This side.
And you're a school teacher?
I am. I teach high school English.
High school English?
High school English.
Is this your first tattoo?
This will be tattoo number 7.
7?
7.
Professional, huh?
It's so funny. I actually got told they don't match the morals and standards of where I live.
When I moved to Georgia, I found out that my lifestyle, my personality really didn't match those I lived with. And the first question I was asked is what church I go to. Well, then getting the head-to-toe survey of my tattoos and the piercings, and with the answer, I don't go to church, I got a lot of negative feedback. It was quite a culture shock from Seattle, Washington.
Completely segregated in a very small town, rural South.
We don't want your kind here, that type of
Oh, yeah.
I love that. That's great. That's
towns, schools, living areas, still very much segregated. We still have a white prom and a black prom. We have a white homecoming queen, a black homecoming queen. I had other teachers telling me I'm not setting a good example for students by not making smart life choices. So it's been kind of tough.
I made sure to tell all the teachers, oh yeah, I'm gonna get another tattoo. Another one?
Oh my God.
Yeah.
What are your children gonna think?
I love my job, I love English, I'm the biggest nerd in the world, I love books, I love what I do, and I especially love the children. I try to cut out the negativity of all the really narrow-minded answers.
Oh, that looks good, I like that.
And, you know, try to encourage them to broaden their ways of thinking. Don't go with just what your mom and dad thought. You know, you have a brain too, use it.
So what's this tattoo mean to you?
I don't know, see, I live in Japan, and I love Japanese culture, I love Japanese history, and I love that the geisha, where it's common reception today, thinking it was some sex thing or prostitution thing.
It's not at all. It has nothing to do with that.
It's about being an educated woman, being a very high social class of woman, you know.
With the geisha tattoo, I think it'll visually represent kind of my global awareness, you know, to show these kids, they'll ask, what is that? You know, is that Chinese? And, you know, it opens that avenue for discussion. No, it's Japanese, and here's some culture, and you should go visit Tokyo. It's a crazy city.
So what color did you decide to go with? Are you gonna stick to the picture?
No. You know, the way Japanese prints are, they're very, almost pastel-y, you know? So sometimes when I do a tattoo, I just like to make a couple of colors stand out more than they usually would. And, you know, little variations of colors that I just thought that will make the tattoo pop out a little more. And that's what I did.
All right, darling.
All done? It's great.
Ami told me I had a surprise, but then he said, well, you know, some surprises aren't good. So he scared me a little bit. But then when I saw what he had done, he had freehanded drawn a koi carp in the fan, and it looks amazing. I couldn't even have imagined it looking like that. It was a nice surprise. It looked really good. That's awesome. So I'm not gonna cry, not gonna do it. He just did an amazing job.
All right.
All right, thank you so much. Thank you, I love it.
My pleasure.
Thank you so much.
Take care.
All right, thank you so much.
Take care.
Thanks a lot, man.
It was my pleasure.